Good morning again. We have to continue our discussion. So, I stopped a while ago so that you will fully understand how to interpret these principles. So, I just cut the discussion so that you can digest it very carefully. So, to continue with our discussion, while ago, I have discussed how to locate the surfaces of the object. So, I hope that you understand that discussion. Now, to continue, we are now going to identify the corners of the object. So, in our front view, if you're going to focus on the front view, there are four corners. So, this is our corner number 1, number 2, number 3, and number 4. If you're going to transfer this surface on the orthographic, this will be our corner 1, number 2, corner number 2, number 3, corner number 4, corner. Now, on the side view, focus your attention on this specific location, or you have to transfer your eyesight on this position. So, we also have four corners. Corner 3, 4, 5, and 6. So, therefore, you are going to write your corner 3, corner 4, corner 5, and corner 6. On the top view, so meaning to say, when we say top view, you have to focus your attention on the arrow that I have drawn. So, there are also four corners. 1, 7, 3, and 5. So, where will be this one? Corner number 1 will be here. Corner number 3, corner number 7, and corner number 5. So, this is now our assignment of the corners referring on our isometric drawing. Now, with regards to principle number 8, the line perpendicular to the plane of projection is projected on that plane as a point. So, in my previous discussion, I have mentioned that how to interpret, but I know that you did not fully understand this principle number 8. So, this is how we are going to interpret this specific principle. So, going back to our front view, you have to focus on your eyesight on the front view. So, take note that there are perpendicular lines that is found in our isometric drawing. So, for example, the line 1 or the corner number 1, I mean, the end point of this line is 7. So, supposing you're going to pull this line 7 towards you, this will become your point. So, therefore, if you're going to pull this one towards you, your number 7 or corner number 7 will be on the number 1. So, meaning to say, this is our line 1, 7 pulled towards you, your number 7 will be transferred here. And also, your number 3 or corner number 3 has a line which is the end point 5. So, if you're going to pull this line 5 or line 3, 5, you will see that the end point of this line 3, 5 is your number 5. So, therefore, so you have to write 5. On the 4th corner, there is also our 6. And the 2nd or 2 corner, this is number 8 or corner number 8. Now, transfer your position on the side view. So, you have to focus on the side view. Don't disregard the other surfaces. You have to focus on the side view. So, we have our surface C. at the end of the line 4, there is our 2. Line 6, there is our 8. Line 5, there is our 7. And line 3, there is 1. Now, last one, focus on your top view. Now, if you're going to look at the top view, surface B, then corners 1, 3, 5, and 7. So, what are the endpoints of these specific corners? So, in our 1, there is 2. Number, corner 3, endpoint is 4. Then 5 is 6. Then 7 is 8. So, this is how we are going to interpret the principles. I hope that you get the idea. Good day.